वी हैव द रिविजनरी क्लिप फॉर द एग्जाम टाइम, ठीक है ना। तो इस तरह से हम लोग रिविजनरी क्लिप भी रिकॉर्ड करेंगे अलग से। सो दिस विल गिव द एक्सेस टू द रिविजनरी क्लिप एंड यू कैन रिवाइज द एंटायर टॉपिक इन द 5 मिनट। सो दिस विल एक्चुअली गिव यू अ लॉट ऑफ बूस्ट टू योर रिविजन मटेरियल। सो व्हाट इज द सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप एज पर द नाबार्ड? सेल्फ हेल्प ग्रुप आर द स्मॉल। सो माई फ्रेंड्स प्लीज बी अटेंटिव, इन जस्ट 5 मिनट वी विल बी रिव्यूइंग द एंटायर टॉपिक। सो साइंटिफिकली इफ यू रीड और लिसन टू समथिंग फॉर द फर्स्ट टाइम यू आर एबल टू रिकॉल मैक्सिमम 30-40%। बट यू इफ यू लिसन टू द सेम थिंग अगेन देन यू आर एबल टू रिकॉल 65-70% ऑफ द सेम मटेरियल, राइट? सो लिसन फ्रॉम दैट पॉइंट ऑफ व्यू, डोंट बी कॉम्प्लेसेंट, डोंट बी लेजी, बी 100% अटेंटिव इन द क्लास, राइट? सो आई हैव नो कंट्रोल ओवर हाउ यू आर सिटिंग, आर यू ईटिंग समथिंग और आर यू लाइंग इन योर बेड, बट बी 100% अटेंटिव। द बेस्ट वे इज टू सिट ऑन द चेयर, द सिट ऑन द चेयर, राइट? बी फॉर्मल, बी अटेंटिव, टेक 100% अटेंशन, डोंट बी लेजी, ठीक है? So let us start the revision of this topic. As per the NABARD, self-help groups are the small informal group of 10 to 20 individuals. They have homogeneous background. They have voluntarily come together for promoting the saving habits. And they have the common cause. Primarily, they are self-governed, peer-controlled. Characteristics. From the point of view of self NABARD, characteristics include that they should be having the homogeneous background, 6 months of existence, successfully undertaken savings and credit operations, democratically working, proper accounts, and helping for genuine need of each other. Principles of self-help group primarily include demand-based lending, spirit of thrift, peer-pressure group-based repayment, and capacity building. Purpose of the loan can be anything, but the main thing is that they are now out of clutch of the private money lenders. The prime motive is multi-fold, starting from saving habit to credit facilities, self-reliance, etc. Historical background, we can see from 1970 in SEWA, then in 1985 NGO Mysore Settlement and Development Agency, it promoted 300 self-help group within 1 year. In 1992, immediately after the economic reforms, we had the NABARD called NABARD program, and in 1997, in the 9th five-year plan, the government introduced the formal invitation, right? The government initiatives, if we see, the government initiatives started from 1992 primarily in the form of self-help group bank linkage program. Then in 1993, the government allowed opening of the saving account. In 1999, Swarna Jayanti Gram Swaraj Ghar Yojana. In 2011, National Rural Livelihood Mission. Then Mallikam Committee recommended that for the microfinance building in India, self-help groups are very, very important. Priority sector lending is also given to the self-help group. Deen Dayal Antyodaya Yojana of 2015 program, and then Mudra loan of up to rupees 1 lakh for the women in every self-help group. 5,000 rupees are given as the overdraft for the general account holders who are the self-help group members. Self-help group bank linkage program by the SK Kale committee recommendation. 3 models. In the model 1, 100% by the bank. In the model 2, promotion by the NGO or government, financing by the bank. In the model 3, promotion by the NGO and financing by the bank using the NGO as the financial intermediary. Apart from that, there are 3 important government promoted popular self-help groups: Kudumbashri in Kerala, Jivika in Bihar, and Mahila Arthik Vikas Mahamandal in the Maharashtra. Now, let us see the role, etc. Role of the self-help groups, we can see at the individual level, society level, governance level, women empowerment for the financial and economic success. Starting from the finance, number 1, saving, Then microfinance, employment and livelihood, for example, Legit Thapad, banking literacy, financial inclusion, all this actually strengthens the financial position. Secondly, at the individual and family level, increases the confidence and capability, more participation of women in the decision making, peace at home, and increasing the nutrition level, which increases the self-help group indicators, self-help SDG indicators. Governance, for the governance, they get more access to the government schemes, local government participation increases, and role of pressure group is also played by the self-help group. Rural poverty alleviation is also done by the self-help group. Balanced regional development, because they are located in the remote areas and they represent human face of the development. They give boost to the spirit of DPSP in the form of social, economic, political justice. For the women empowerment, they are also contributing in the form of increasing the leadership skills, reducing the social stigma. More social responsibility is being undertaken by the women, common problem solving, and ultimately leading to the improved gender development indicators in the form of sex ratio improvement in the total fertility rate, institutional deliveries, etc. For the community development, they help more community participation, which increases the strength of democracy. Social integrity, because people from different religion, caste, background, they come together, it gives voice to the marginalized. Cultural advancement, because the product can be taken from the rural area to the international level and revise the rural art and culture. Recently, their participation in the COVID-19 management, Ashmita Plus rolled in the sanitary pads. One district, one product scheme can be successful with the help of self-help group only. And the ban on the plastic, leading to the more production of disposable bags by the self-help group. Now let us see the issues faced by the self-help groups. At the organizational level, they are not registered, so that actually questions their credibility. Then poor accounting and misappropriation of fund, lack of training, lack of formal training, which stops their full participation in the banking and government activities. They are primarily involved in the primitive activities, not in the manufacturing and service sector, which reduces their per capita income and reduces the sustainability. Lack of complementary background, which actually becomes one of the problem, because they are not able to support each other much. They face discrimination from the banking sector. They have limited support infrastructure in the form of digitization, roads, electricity, because they are working in the rural areas. They also have limited rural banking, around 1.2 lakh branch for the 6 lakh villages. So that actually restricts the benefit of the banking programs. They are over dependent upon the NGOs and government. Patriarchal mindset, social stigma, household responsibilities, that stops the full participation of the women, and they are limited to the South India and the rural areas. Now, what can be the way forward? The government support is required in the form of Model Self-Help Group Act, which talks about registration, which will give the data, and digitization should be there. Minimum government purchase can be there. Expansion into the urban areas, credit starved regions, and tribal and poor regions can be there. For the capacity building, there can be a federation of self-help groups. NGOs and banks, they can adopt the self-help group, right? Entrepreneurship culture can be promoted with the help of providing the concept of SHG moles, SHG hearts, and need-based funding, skill development, raw material, etc. Andhra Pradesh government Panchsutra can be adopted, which focuses upon small membership, transparent lending, regular meetings, timely recovery, and the digitization. For it, ultimately, we should try to convert them from simply saving institutions to the developmental change agents. Right? So this is the complete revision of the topic.